You have a good job. You have a career. You do the things that you're supposed to do. You get a worm in your brain. The worm tells you, stop being a nobody. Stop being a little person in a little life. You think, I don't want to go to work. You think, I don't want to do the things that I'm supposed to do. You stop getting up in the morning. The worm says, you will not serve. The worm says, you will not obey. The worm says,
Holly's making a movie about me being a fucko.
What do you say?
I said she's making a movie about me being just a total fucko.
What?
She's making a movie about me being a loser.
Who?
Me.
What?
Because I am a loser.
What's she doing?
What?
What's she lost?
What have I lost? My life.
How?
Because I've just given up because I don't care anymore.
Why?
Why? I don't know why.
You look alright all the time.
Well, I do look alright.
What are you going to do?
I don't know what I'm going to do. Hopefully I'm not going to kill myself within the next couple weeks. Yeah, I won't do that. But I still look good, according to the creepy guy in the store, right? It's like, why have you given up? You still look good. Shh. My arms! Look at my soul!
All of us agree that the gravest domestic threat facing our nation today is drugs. This is crack cocaine, seized a few days ago by drug enforcement agents in a park just across the street from the White House. It's as innocent looking as candy, but it's turning our cities into battle zones, and it's murdering our children. Let there be no mistake, this stuff is poison.
Yeah, see, most people would be freaked out by this situation, but I just don't care about anything anymore. Do I just like crave drama to come to me?
Does she?
I don't know.
Such a nihilist.
Why? Because, you know, I don't really see any way out. Because there is the way out of actually making money and being successful, but that doesn't really fucking make you happy either. So, if that doesn't make you happy, and being poor is just about the same, except that you have more freedom, I mean, it just, nothing really fucking matters. Maybe I'd feel differently, like, if I was a dictator of a small country or something. Because then stuff would have to kind of matter. You know, because you'd have like all these people trying to kill you and, but you know, no, nothing matters. Isn't everybody kind of turning into a nihilist these days? I don't know too many people that care about anything. Except self-preservation. but I'm knowing fewer and fewer people that are interested in that.
The evil, evil works we do.
Okay, sit still.
I'm sitting still.
Let's see, let me see if I can find the ad I took out yesterday trying to sell my integrity, or not yesterday, the other day, last week, trying to sell my integrity, Molly. It really pissed a lot of people off. They did not find it amusing, and it got, I published it on like 5 different Craigslists, and most of them got like removed. I think it's under general for sale. Let's see if we can find it. Integrity.
Okay, head down.
Integrity, dirt cheap, $25,000. Hi, no one wants to be plagued by guilt or overridden with self-loathing. So if you possess 1 ounce of human compassion, read up. Okay, so I start still convincing Gallo as a way to distract myself from my own destructive nature. I don't know why I thought it would work, except I think he was born on the same day as my crazy-ass dog. Anyway, it seemed to have worked. I'm focused, spiteful, and ready to leave San Francisco. Why? Because the city and the creeps in it are suffocating me. New York is my next move because I'm self-centered and hate people. Because of this, I tend to get lonely and need to have easy access to others. That said, I'm going to have to hustle my ass off and temporarily abandon my morals. Anyway, the aforementioned diabolical plan is going to be rough because I'm ethical and honest to a fault. These are not necessarily admirable traits, and I will do everything I can to keep them at bay. I have to learn how to lie. I hear the audiobook, Never Be Lied to Again, is a great guide. I'm checking it out of the library tomorrow. This is where you come in. Do you want to be responsible for my lost integrity? No way! So by my honesty, I figure $25,000 is a fair price. Nobody's, like, ponied up with the cash.
Head down!
Okay. I posted it, like, in 10 different places, and nobody's done anything. Can you guys believe that?
Seems like Vincent Gallo should buy your integrity.
I think he should. Do you want to send him an email to that effect? Because he's not talking to me anymore. What?
So why did I give you $30 the other day?
I bought cocaine.
I bought
cocaine?
Yes.
And
fuck!
And you didn't do anything.
What?
Yeah.
I bought cocaine and I didn't do any?
You did one line and Gabby and Trish, well, they tried to take it and then I grabbed it back and gave it back, but then you kept giving it to him like, I don't know.
Okay, whatever. Well, at least I didn't do any of it.
Well, you did one little line.
Well, that doesn't count.
You did get high.
I'm drug free.
You did get high, you fell out of your chair and I don't remember, but you were fucked up.
You guys don't let me buy cocaine when I'm shit-faced drunk.
I won't. I'm not going to let you do drugs. Remember I said that. You can't do drugs.
I don't want any of the drugs.
What the fuck are you talking about?
Okay. Soap.
Okay.
Ha ha ha. Come on in.
So how easy is it to get drugs in San Francisco?
Pretty fucking easy. That was just a pretty good demonstration of it. If I want cocaine or heroin or Special K, all I need to do is ask my roommates, and they will trot down the street and buy it for me. If I'm drunk and it's after 2 and I want to buy some crack, I just have to go up to the corner, and within 5 minutes, the crack be had. I don't smoke pot because that's for hippies, but that's even easier to get. But the easiest of all drugs to get is heroin in the Mission, and $20 will get you fucked up for 2 days straight. So basically, it's set up to turn people into junkies. Luckily, I'm not really into downers or heroin at all, so it's not really a problem. Although I have OD'd twice in the past year. Okay.
So, So Julie seems like she's on drugs.
Becky, you need help.
Look at her.
She can't even operate the washing machine. She's wrecked.
What's wrong?
Who wants to go Mad Emerald Series Double Order Plus? Can you have problems?
Yes, it is.
Yeah, push the start button and look what happens.
She's doing circles around the laundromat. Look! She's doing laps. She's got so much energy.
Where are you on?
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
What are you on?
Nothing.
Look at her.
Not on anything. I had a burrito today. I had a cup of coffee this morning at 8. Not on anything.
She's crazy. She's on amphetamines.
I'm not on amphetamines right now.
What's Becky doing? What the fuck does she think? Look at, she's totally dissing us right now. Who the fuck does she think she is? She thinks you're on crack.
Right now?
Yeah.
She's never seen anybody smoke crack. She's done, she thinks like, you know, because she can go through a gram of cocaine in like a weekend, she has a problem. I tell her I can go through a gram of cocaine in an hour. Easy. And do.
I just decided to put crack zone stickers up all over the neighborhood because you can buy crack everywhere, and it's not good for me to be able to buy crack at any time of the day or night when I want to. So I just thought I'd start putting up warning stickers so other people would know the dangers of entering the crack zone.
It's funny, like yesterday, or this morning at like 4, Sean and I are like lying around in his room watching TV under all the blankets with space heaters pointing at us because it's so fucking freezing in the house and there's no heat.
I used to have a normal life like this.
Then I had heat and everything.
I knew that I had to move out after the time I came home from the beach with Eli and we found Julie convulsing in her room on an overdose of some spray can of dust off she had been inhaling, and we had to call the ambulance, and it was kind of a traumatic experience, you know, because we had to hold her down and we thought she was going to die. I thought she was dying, but then I realized she didn't think it was much of a big deal, and I was like, well, I can't stay, really, and watch her self-destruct because I can't do anything about it. You know, it's her life. And not very long after that, I moved out a couple weeks later because she didn't stop. She was just up and partying again like a day and a half later. And so, yeah, but I love Julie. Love Julie. Too much fun.
Are you gonna perk up?
If I'm gonna what?
Are you gonna perk up and be happy?
Yeah, just chill out. She found 20 beers yesterday.
Oh yeah, did I tell you about the 20 beers that I found?
Yeah.
20 beers. Check this beer out. Look at this logo from like 19 or the 1800th century.
Did you just grab two beers?
Yeah, one for you guys.
I don't know if I'm going to
get a bicycle one.
Do you want a beer? Because I don't.
I'll get the Indian pale.
Remember, it was found on the street and I have no idea how old it is.
It's pretty old. That one look very old, like 20 years. It's stashed.
It's not 20 years like old. Stashed. Give me a fucking break. And nobody got sick yesterday drinking it. And it has a website address on it, so that means this beer is at less than 5 years old. Okay?
Okay.
So we're okay, I think. But I don't know what the half-life on beer is. Could still die. But everybody's gonna die anyway, so it doesn't really fucking matter. Ask me something, I feel boring.
When do you think the world's gonna end?
I think it already has. See, that's the thing. Nobody's getting it. We're all in some really fucked up, twisted purgatory right now, and nothing's really real.
I don't know.
Yeah, it is, trust me. Or maybe it's just my private purgatory and you guys are just all players in it. And Raheem's like the devil. You heard me, devil dog.
What, it was a dream?
No, it's not a dream. No, like, I'm dead right now. I'm dead and this is just some twisted, like, little creepy mindscape that I'm stuck in. Because, you know, I have to prove I'm good so God will let me into heaven. But, you know, I don't know if I believe in God, and I think that might be the problem.
But you call God all the time.
Well, I know.
What are you doing tonight?
I don't know. I don't have any money. What do you know? Just taping. You don't know what it's like. Yeah, can you tell behind this face, behind the nanny angel face, there's an evil, evil nanny? At least I don't do drugs at my work. So watch out, kids. Watch out, because the nanny's in the hood. The nanny's in the hood. The nanny's in the hood.
This is the valley called Mamarungo, home of about 500 of the almost 12,000 Kogis living in these mountains. This tribe lives in almost Stone Age conditions, protected from modern civilization by a grueling two-day trek along narrow mountain footpaths. This plant is the cause of most of the problems of the Kogi society. This is the source of cocaine, the famous coca bush. These are the leaves which are processed to produce cocaine. The Kogi society centers around the coca bush. The Kogis cultivate coca in relatively small plots for their own use only. These coca bushes are very well maintained. Unfortunately, however, this leaves little time for cultivation of anything else.
That's like, what do you do when you're fucking wasted? You pee outside because the line is, the line is too big.
Look at Meandros. This is like a fucking river.
Rolling on a river. Shake, shake, shake. Put the pants up. And that's it.
Is the devil a fallen angel?
That's the idea, that they are all fallen angels. The idea is that once upon a time, one third of the angels of God revolted against him and were condemned to hell and became demons.
What was the purpose of that rebellion, Doctor?
The purpose of the rebellion was simply the ambition of one spirit, Lucifer, who said, I will not serve. I will be equal to God. And there was this, supposedly, this huge battle between the spirits, and the demons lost. And forever, the fallen angels, those who rebelled, are condemned to hell and condemned to be evil and to promote evil amongst human beings.
All right, no, don't.
Leave me alone for a fucking day, that's it.
I am the one that should leave you alone, you know?
No, well, you can't say you're gonna fucking kill yourself.
Here, hold on.
All right, you better not do anything stupid.
Oh, yeah,
I love you and care about you.
You know what? You're the best friend I ever, ever had.
It's not that bleak. It'll be okay. I'm gonna call you in half an hour.
Rest in peace,
Captain. Fuck you! Gabby!
What?
Don't be so fatalistic.
What?
It's cute, but only for a second. Probably didn't handle that right, did I? I don't know what to do. I really don't.
I really care about her and she's really sweet. And I don't want her to fucking die. And I don't want her to do what she's doing. But there doesn't seem to be anything I can do to stop it. I had her going to NA for a week. I went with her every day. And she didn't drink, except for NyQuil at night, which is, you know, come on, I'm all for people taking baby steps. You know, go ahead, drink a bottle of NyQuil at midnight and get yourself fucked up out of your mind and pass out. Because that meant she was only fucked up for the 8 hours she was sleeping. She was sober for the other 16. And she was doing really well. But she has this inner desire for people to love her so much, and she feels the only way she can get that is by being wasted. And unfortunately, I'm the only person out of this whole fucking crowd that can see that. Everybody else is just fucking me. And it breaks my fucking heart. All right, I have to pee. Right, my, okay, yeah, there's somebody with the box. Hi, buddy. Fuck. I don't know, what do you think? What do you think is in order now? What do I do about this? I mean, I don't owe anything to her. I shouldn't feel responsible. But I don't want her to completely, I don't want her to fucking die. Because she's a beautiful, loving girl. And she shouldn't be dead.
The Kogi men frequently stay in the men's council house all night long and often go 3 to 4 days without food or sleep while under the effects of cocaine. To the Kogis, the use of the narcotic coca is a serious spiritual commitment. Kogis believe that they are the center of the universe, and that the sun rises and sets due to their spiritual intervention through use of the coca. They believe that they bring the seasons and are upset when the outside world refuses to acknowledge the importance of their accomplishments.
Here's another bat that I'm ready to speak. It kept slaps, making snaps.
On the cocaine bus, don't you know?
Pup Tent, call me if you can front us something. Otherwise, forget about it.
Going to roll so hard all the time. You and that bitch playing two short rhymes. If you ask me what it's all about, I'll say it's about that Monday.
Yeah. Here you go.
Hey,
don't you know,
so I'm
when I'm on the camera
Sean
though,
we're trying to get stuff, and we
Julie.
We're hoping to get Graham, but we'd have to pay you next week. We'd have to pay you next week, so it's up to you. Like by Friday. I'm at my house. All right, bye.
How easy was that?
Too easy. That's just sick and wrong. No, I'm shooting mine. You can make crack with the rest of it. You're not shooting anything because needles are dull. So, I don't want you to hurt your veins.
Show me your steed. Show me your steed right now.
What?
Show me your steed.
They're dull. Look what happens.
What are you doing now? It's your beautiful body.
What?
Why do you do that to your beautiful self?
Oh, it's because I was, like, too anxious. The only way you get what I have right here is if you miss. The only reason this is this swollen is because I went through my vein and the cocaine went into the skin around here.
What do you think about when you look at that?
Nothing, actually. It doesn't hurt me any either way.
Do you think you have pride off that?
I have. The only pride I have is that I don't hold back and I don't lie. If I ever lied to any motherfuckers about this, if I ever hidden it.
But do you think you're setting a good example for those people out there?
To an extent, because who wants to wind up like me in their 30s and a fuck up? Come on, Colin, you're 10 years younger than me. You don't want to be me in 10 years, do you? Yeah, so am I a good example or a bad example? I'm a good example because you don't want to be me.
No. You got me wrong.
Need something to... Do you have a
You got a rubber band?
Yeah, I need something because I don't want to miss again.
Wait. Don't do it without fucking...
I know, I'm waiting. I'm just trying to...
You're tripping. Everything here.
No, I'm just like...
Here. Take off your jacket for a minute. Here. Be a lot easier.
Let me help.
You know this is disgusting, and I don't approve it.
Yeah, but...
You'd be smoking weed and listening to reggae.
Yeah, I should be, but, you know, I'm just not that much of a hippie, man. This coke is so weak. Like, that should be enough to, like... So weak. It's...
Sorry.
All I'm feeling is it in my mouth and not getting orgasms. Because that's what
define
you should
a, get. Define a cocaine orgasm.
When you shoot cocaine, like real cocaine... You get about 100 orgasms at once.
I'm sorry, I poured way too much. I'll put it back in your bag, though.
No, don't worry about it. You guys can have this. I don't care.
Do you ever... Oh, wait. Do I?
I really don't care. I'm over it. Like, whatever. I don't... No,
you should have put anything in your bones, period.
I know, but I started so young, and it was just, like, what I did.
It's crazy.
Yeah, it's totally crazy. I mean, you need to have, like, people that actually know what's going on.
That's how you do dope.
No, that's not how you do dope.
I have my opinion, and you have yours.
This is bad dope, though. It doesn't give you, like...
Well, you know, you can think whatever you want. I like doing my drugs. I'm not gonna say you're doing your shit wrong.
No, I was a really young kid, and I was just, like, introduced to, like...
If I was, like, 13 and saw somebody shoot up, I'd trip out.
I just, like, it's, like, whatever.
Yeah. Like I said, like, you grew up learning your shit, like, the way you people did drugs around you, and I grew up, you know, totally
But
different.
No, he did it around me. It was just, like, but when it was introduced, it was just, like, whatever.
Yeah. I don't care. Like, yeah, I just held your arm, you know what I'm saying? It's like, you do your shit your way, I do my shit my way.
What's my life right now? My life is just being a graffiti
artist.
What's
anybody's life right now? It's
like,
bullshit.
I've just given up. But
you
see,
never
I don't,
give up.
I've given up.
You should never give up. Never.
I have. I just want to be like a little graffiti artist that doesn't really care.
Don't ever give up, dude.
I mean, like, that's the thing. And I might have given up on like living like a normal life, but I'm still myself.
Because the angels in heaven are waiting, and they're rejoicing at what they see and what they hear tonight. Thank you.
Fresh this morning?
Oh God. I need to move. I need to get out of the little ghetto Melrose place. Okay, where are my fucking socks? Why this is all happening is everybody's fucking given up. There's nothing good. There's nothing good that can happen. So why not just fuck up completely? It's not that it's fun. It's not that all of us are like going, woo, we're having so much fun doing all these drugs. Everybody's doing them because there's nothing else. And it's like, it's kind of a dare, like, okay, society, You're not giving me any opportunities, so I'm gonna really fuck up. And that's what it is. It's a giant fucking dare. And guess what? We're losing. Graffiti markers. Oh, great. We get to walk up to the corner. This is going to suck.
Why?
Because there's, like, fucking evil crackheads that think I owe them money, but I really don't, because Eli stopped me from buying the crack. So they're contending that I owe them money for crack that I never got. The crackhead's latest threat is, we're going to just see how you look with short hair and a long skirt. Yeah, the little midget. That's the woman I think that's gonna give me short hair and a long skirt.
Short hair and a long skirt?
Yeah, the woman that thinks I owe her $6 because I was trying to buy crack and Eli stopped me.
You were yelling at them.
Well, they're fuckers, man. I didn't buy any crack from them. I don't owe them any money. I mean, that's just stupid. They think they think because I'm a fucking white kid, they can, like, make me pay for drugs I never got. And their crack sucks ass anyway. It really does.
How about that fatty over there?
That guy? Oh, yeah. You can get drugs from him. That's why she's talking to him. Anybody that's out here, like, if you guys had $20 right now, I could walk out and get, like, a bunch of crack from talking to any of those people.
What do you say? Can I get some crack?
I just go, you just walk by and they know. When you want something, you walk by and they go, what do you want? The rocks. But see, the little midget guy is weird because
he's all retarded, dude.
He's retarded from smoking crack. Why these people get retarded is they go weeks without sleeping. And if you go weeks without sleeping, your brain's shuts down. It basically induces schizophrenia.
Well, you can't sleep when you're crack?
Well, no, the thing about crack is you never get as high as you want to get.
Why?
Because it's a teaser drug. It's a teaser drug. So, you know, so you're constantly chasing this high. You're constantly trying to get as high as you want to get. And so, like, see all these people? Like, all these people, they don't sleep. I can bring you back here at 4 a.m. tonight, and they'll all be there.
You have a point. They're always there, dude.
They're always there. They don't sleep.
I mean, I recognize
the sleeping thing, Gabby?
I recognize the guys with the glasses. I mean, I see them all the time.
Right, well, you see him all the night. He's actually a nice guy. He's retarded, but he's nice.
Who, the midget?
Yeah, the midget's nice.
Butt crack from both the guy in the red jacket and the midget. April 26th.
Like, when we walk out of here, they'll both probably go, hey, Julie, what's up? Trying to be like my friend.
Yeah,
fuckers.
Together, as a people, we can save these kids. We've already transformed a national attitude of tolerance into one of condemnation. But the war on drugs will be hard won, neighborhood by neighborhood, block by block, child by child. If we face this evil as a nation united, this will be nothing but a handful of useless chemicals. Victory. Victory over drugs is our cause, a just cause. And with your help, we are going to win.
Also, I talked to Colin a while last night. We both think maybe you should go back to Brazil and go to school.
Yeah.
I mean, I love you and I'm gonna miss you horribly, but I'm gonna come visit. But I don't think in this environment you can get your head straight.
Fuck.
Chief.
But look at them. They're drinking the drugs.
Well,
what's the fucking difference, you know?
Well, so do I. But the difference is that you're this young, beautiful girl and you don't have to get fucking bogged down in this. And Sean's just as much of a fuck up as both of us.
But the reason that I care, the reason that Colin cares, and the reason that Sean cares, is we're fucking trying to, like, make you not turn out like us. Because you don't have to. You don't have to
That's
turn
late.
Out like us.
That's too late.
It's not too late.
So they worry about me, they think I'm a fucked up?
It's because you're not a fuck up. You're just like us. The only reason they aren't like that with me is because I'm fucking 10 years older than they are. But and so I'm already lost. The only reason they're mean is because they want you to not end up like us.
I know, but man, I'm gonna go crazy in Brazil. I'm gonna go crazy then.
Well, maybe you don't have to go to Brazil, but you have to move out of this neighborhood, and I probably should move out of it as well.
Yeah, that's fucking ghetto.
U.S. policy has been to say that drug trafficking is way up at the top of our national priorities. But in practice, when the policymakers are confronted with the really the enormity of the situation and looking at national security and the economic factors, they are unwilling or unable to confront the issue.
Okay, Ivan.
For Washington, free trade is more important than drugs. When the free trade agreement was being negotiated, Ross Perot warned of a huge sucking sound as American jobs were swallowed up by factories on the other side of the border. There was a reverse sucking sound, not of jobs, but of drugs, as American consumers gorged on Mexican narcotics.
Oh, great, look, there's the cops.
The cops, like, not coming this way. I mean, I should not have been riding with them. Hey, what's
like
up, man?
I like your crazy outfit.
Oh, do you?
What parties do you go to like this?
I don't go to parties. This is just me waking up in the morning, hungover, and dressing. This is just me, man.
You don't go to crazy fetish parties.
I do not go to fetish
you
parties.
You should.
I should? Why?
Because it's fun.
It's fun?
What is that?
She's making a movie about my downfall.
Why? What caused your downfall? Too much cigarette?
No, raw apathy.
Apathy?
Mm-hmm.
Towards what?
Everything.
Why don't you become an avid cyclist?
An avid cyclist?
No, this sounds funny, but sometimes when you mean things very seriously, they come out funny. Start riding. I'm serious.
I do ride.
How many miles a day?
No, I'm not riding, I write.
You
but
ride,
you
no,
this?
I saw.
You want to see, you want to know what those bruises right there are from?
On a demonstration, a cop harmed you?
No, a cop would never harm me, I'm too white. No, those are from my friend grabbing my arm so I could shoot cocaine, because I couldn't get any veins to come up. That's what those are from.
No, what I said, not riding,
right.
riding. Yeah, and are you riding at the moment?
No,
a little bit?
No. I don't
because
do anything.
You do, let's say, maybe 10 miles the first day,
uh-huh.
Then increase it to 15 gradually.
You know that this neighborhood is full of crack?
I heard about it, but you see, I have never ever done any drug, not even marijuana in my life. Never even tried it. So the whole crack scene ignores me, and I ignore it. It's kind of non-establishment. It's kind of either anti-establishment or what the establishment would be against. But there actually there's a lot of crack. It's not that obvious to me. Is it obvious to you?
That there is a major evil spirit called Lucifer, and there is another one called Satan, and they are accompanied by, or they are among, many, many smaller demons, and these do attack and possess human beings in their will and their intellect if in your life there is some imperative coming out of left field, not of your choice, but commanding you, urging you to do something, to yield, to be controlled, and know that that can herald demonic activity. The same demon inhabits the members of the same family for generations. The children are trained in it, and they perpetuate it in their children. It has gone on for generations. It's generational. So daughters to whom their mother attached her familiar, her evil spirit, and then we have the job of ridding them of that. And it takes time, and it's painful. But the truth is this, the horrible truth is this, that if there is a demon in your life, and he dictates your behavior, at least in one province of life, one area of life, he can only be expelled by direct confrontation.
It's just like, you know, getting cookies at a store. You know, you can go anywhere and get it.
This is Jano. You remember the 5 deaths from the Hate-3? I just came back from Hungary 2 weeks ago, and guess what? I just talked to Molly. I heard you quit doing drugs. That's great. Let's go for a bike ride. Talk to you soon. Bye.
Yo, get back to me.
Consequence of cocaine use is the insidious way it warps the mind of even a casual user.
Okay, thank you, bye.
Colombia's survival as the oldest democracy in Latin America is now at risk, but also is the safety of your streets. The cartels fight back against our police and military, because narcos are protecting a multi-billion dollar enterprise that is funded by the cocaine habit of some of you, which are watching me now.
My brother was just the fucking only fucking brother I had, you know? And I can't believe it. And when I noticed he was fucking shot,
what drugs was your brother doing?
He was just doing coke. They were coked out when he was killed.
And no cowboy went riding out one dark and windy day. Upon a ridge he rested as he went along his way. When all at once a mighty herd of red-eyed cows he saw, a plowing through the ragged skies and up a cloudy draw.
Could be.
A bolt of fear went through him as it thundered through the sky. For saw the riders coming hard,
and heard their mournful cry.
Yippee-yi-yi,
yippee-yi-yi. Stop it. Stop whining. Stop it.
Okay, we're gonna walk over there. I'm gonna leave you here. Yeah, I'm gonna leave you here to sleep for a second. If you wake up in an hour, come by, okay?
No, I don't wanna just stay here.
But you should take a nap.
I was by myself.
What? You? Oh, want
I
me
hate
put,
to be by myself.
I know you do. I'll put a movie on for you, okay?
Why? You don't want me to go? I mean, just go to my house.
Well, it's yeah. I'm just saying you're really drunk. I don't want those guys to fuck
so
with you.
So
what? All I'm saying is that they will be mean at this point.
Oh, they
and
will.
You are very sensitive. And when people are mean to you, you get very upset. No,
I know exactly what they say about me, and I know exactly what they think about me. Fuck it, like. Fuck someone that you love it and no, excuse me, you know what? These people will never be my friends. I don't care. I mean, I love them anyways. Whatever.
She's also gonna let it spill that Sean and I were shitty drugs. She'll let it spill that I fucked Andrew. She'll let it spill that I fucked Colin. It's gonna be horrid. So how long do you think we have till she like passes out? Okay. You can subtitle this part if you want. Whispering so we don't enrage the coquette Brazilian nanny. Okay, it wasn't like I was trying to stop do drugs today. It's not like I woke up and going, I'm gonna stop doing drugs. It's just like, okay, whatever. I did it last night. I don't need to do it today. I'm fine. I don't. And stuff like this fucking cements it to hell. And Jesus fuck, man. Like I said, it's like I only have so much. I can barely like make myself wake up in the morning and go, hey, it's a fabulous day, which I never do. But fuck, I mean, I can't be everyone's fucking parent. And besides, I'm a horrible influence. I should probably just drop out and let them all die by themselves.
Is that all there is? Is that all there is? If that's all there is, my friend, I know what you must be saying to yourselves. If that's the way she feels about it, why doesn't she just end it all? Oh, no, not me. I'm not ready for that final disappointment. 'Cause I know, just as well as I'm standing here talking to you, that when that final moment comes, and I'm breathing my last breath, I'll be saying to myself, is that all there is? Is that all there is? If that's all there is, my friends, then let's keep dancing. Let's break out the booze and have a ball. If that's
oh no, I'm not gonna have you guys do my laundry. I was gonna say I don't have any clean clothes, but I have laundry set up that I was going to do today. I was gonna say somebody should do my laundry. So that way I would have a clean outfit upon getting out. And if I had a clean outfit upon getting out, I would like to wear my black small underwear, my pink Abercrombie and Fitch shirt, my black tank top that with the VSBA thing on it, and my fur Gucci hat, which is on top of my Angel. Osmond gave me a Gucci hat, and my diesel jacket, and a new pair of stockings. But the pink skirt, the underwear, and the stockings are all in the dirty clothes bag that is on the floor near the hamper in my bedroom. Because I want to look fabulous when I leave. Toothbrush.
What's wrong with your
arm? I have cellulitis, which means cocaine's very toxic, and so there's a ton of toxins in my arm that need to be drained out. And it's causing tissue damage right now. And I know this is stupid, and I know you shouldn't shoot cocaine, I know all of that stuff, everybody. But instead of staging intervention, why don't you stage getting me a job? Or giving me a reason to live?
See, there it is. They replaced the curtains with theirs. And I don't even know who lives there anymore.
Natalie thinks the place is haunted.
Natalie thinks it's haunted?
By an evil spirit.
Yeah, in that way.
And she says that it just makes people crazy.
And I always felt kind of a weird vibe in that house. Not a spiritual thing, but just something that didn't feel all too right. But maybe a part of it was because of the energy that Julie creates, which at all times, which is really ironic, she could be very maternal and you feel like everything's okay because she seems to have the answer to things. She's a really bright, one of the sharpest people that I have had the pleasure to meet. But ironically, one of the people that have really lost touch of her own reality.
It's like you're talking about her like she's dead.
Yeah, it feels like somebody had almost like gone and passed away, and then there's this spirit or this just kind of certain feeling.
How are you gonna quit? Are you gonna quit?
Well, I have to right now because there's nothing I could hit if you paid me. There's no way. If you give me a gram of awesome cocaine right now, there's not a goddamn thing in the world I could do with it. There's nothing I could do. I could not get it into my body. Well, actually, I could. What I would do, if you gave me a gram of cocaine right now, what I would do is I would hook the syringe up to one of my three input devices here, stuck in my trusty little super vein in my groin, and I would just shoot it in there. So if I stay in the hospital, I don't have to quit doing drugs because I can just shoot them into my handy little groin vein. But left to my own devices, I can't shoot drugs anymore because there's nothing I can hit. I don't have any veins left. They couldn't give me an IV anywhere except there. What's not only funny is that you guys are here, but they let you film him giving me my pain medication. See, all right, Molly, my theory is right. We're already dead.
It doesn't matter where Julie's at, whether she's in New Orleans or Florida or Vermont or LA or New York or here in the Lower Heights. She'll always find the drug, she'll always find whatever new addiction she has because it's not relative to the place that she's at, it's what's inside of her, as cheesy as that sounds. So if you're a junkie, you'll find it and people will find you.
Thank you.
got all sad when I saw Marc Jacobs ad and it showed the San Francisco address of the store because there's nowhere here to go and look at pretty things. Sometimes I go to Saks and look around. I'm only treated like a normal person here in Gucci. It's the only place where people treat me like a human being. So I started making the Walgreens across the street get both Vogue and Elle. They get them just for me. And Raheem was subscribing to them for a while, but they stopped sending him his subscription because he wasn't paying his bill.
What happened when your dad died?
Nothing. I went down to Key West. It was weird. I got into a fight with Rob and he left me here.
So tell me where you work right now.
I work at McNair Elementary School, teaching little ghetto children how to make art.
Where else do you work?
I work at Big Daddy's. World famous strip club.
Hey, grab a dictionary. That might be easier.
Will
you grab a dictionary and look up vulture for me? He is right before W.
Ooh, vulgarity. Vulture, they've got pictures. We are set.
This is a picture of a pretty little vulture.
So, do you guys have all your flowers taken down?
No.
All right, so let's start on your bee project. And if you're gonna work on the queen, it's over there.
I am for her. I'm waiting for her to finish the queen.
With animation, and then.
The power of the assassin. He has no will of the assassin. Father of young son. Yes, the power of the assassin blade, he will never surrender nor give up.
After the showcase.
Yeah.
Ah, ha, ha, ha.
Ah. I am the queen. I'm gonna animate a vulture. It's gonna be flying.
I have a little chicken.
Hey, you, Desmond, come over here.
Come over here.
We can animate his arms like that. Now, do you want to do his legs too? Okay, so cut him off. You know what I mean?
It'll matter.
And then I need you. Do you know how to spell ninja?
Yes.
All right. I need you to spell out ninja and then cut out the letters and then we'll do yours when it's all ready. Okay.
You want to make a pow?
All right. So check it out. So this like this would be inch. You think you can make the worm letters? Each little inch thing is going to be moving. We'll do it in stop motion. So it will be like wiggly. So it will be like the whole word is alive. So you want to do the worm part?
That's a little too big.
It's gonna be a lot of animating. I'm gonna have to help you animate it, okay? You might have to have a couple people help you animate it. But it will be yours.
Painful!
It's painful making flowers. How close are you? Got it?
Sorry!
Oh, that is so cool. We're ready for the next project.
Desmond,
what?
Where to put the letter J?
Blue, blue,
cute,
blue.
Hey,
alrighty.
Desmond, stop being so cranky.
Desmond,
what is the matter with you?
Are we ready?
We are. Okay, Desmond, we're ready.
Just move the legs just a little bit more.
I can't get
up.
Come on, come
on,
with
brain.
Toothpaste.
And
toothbrush.
What the?
Okay, no brushing your teeth in class.
You can stop.
Okay. Okay, ready? Inchworms up.
Ready.
Okay, come here. I'll get the take a picture. This is gonna take forever.
Alright.
See, watch what I'm doing so you can take over.
Could somebody make sure that there aren't any pencils or pens and play on the floor?
So first I'm just gonna make
the branches.
Yeah.
Whoa. No, that's it. You guys, if you guys touch each other again, one of you is sitting out in the hallway.
You get up and go draw. Go draw like an elephant ripping the head off an alligator.
Oh, Dad!
Excellent, guys. Alexa says exactly what I envisioned this morning. Okay, you, come here. Guess what you're gonna do? You can't clean up.
You're gonna go in this corner over here, and you're gonna do jumping jacks until you are tired. Start. Go. Okay, just keep doing that.
See what I mean?
That's it. I'm not putting up with this next week. If I have to deal with this, everybody's going home. You guys, you need to pick up your flowers so we can shoot it today. Don't you want to shoot that project today?
I don't care.
All right, so do you want to help putting the flowers on there so we can shoot your project next?
Yeah, we're going to help each other.
Yes, and can you help each other without like hitting each other and teasing each other and flirting with each other?
Flirting!
You heard me.
Flirting!
This is the naughtiest thing I've ever been. But they got the coolest. You? And then I go into the strip club. Alright, let's
what?
Go. Then I go into the bar where I work. Alright. Oh. He's like, I'm a bartender in the quarter.
You just said you were
the same. I know. I'm not that. She knows because she goes to work with me. I'm not. I'm a bartender. Bartime Molly.
That was the first time I've ever taken my clothes off. I have a hard time taking my clothes in front of my boyfriend. Tell me what to do because I don't know.
You know, you should just stand around and watch some dancers. Like, who are some dancers who are real? They all have different styles.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I don't know. I mean, I had two songs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 bucks.
$8, 2 songs? That's not that bad. I mean, because the money's made on the floor doing table dances, lap dances, and going into VIP rooms. It's not really from being on
the
stage.
What do you have to do for VIP rooms?
I don't rightly know, but nobody takes their clothes off. I mean, well, you do, of course. But they're not allowed to take their clothes off. I'd stay here for 15 minutes and see what the other girls are doing because everybody's dressed differently. That's some girls wear dresses. Some girls wear bikinis.
What's the stripper name?
I'm telling you. Indiscretion. Lucky. Indiscretion is the best stripper name ever. Or hijinks.
Does anyone else have it?
No, nobody has indiscretion.
How about Protégé?
Protégé is good. I love Protégé. Oh my god, that's brilliant.
All right, Protégé. Give it up for Protégé.
Mine would be ennui or despair. All right, let's take a break and let me wait on some tables and make some money since I don't have any.
Do you think he'll let me go out again?
Tonight?
Yeah.
Oh, totally. He'll be all over that.
Okay, I think I need some shoes. I don't want
you. Yeah, just go up to Manny and say you want to go up again. He'll love it.
Okay, will you come with me?
Yeah.
All right. Totally.
What do you think about when you think about the stuff that we filmed a year ago?
I don't really think about it. I mean, I don't know. I have not come to any big epiphany in my life. I'm just choosing not to shoot drugs right now for I don't know why. But it's not like I think there was anything intrinsically wrong with my behavior last year. I mean, I really don't. I have no remorse. I should be institutionalized probably. No, I was just doing it. What the fuck is that?
That just fell from the ceiling.
I know. I guess the South is full of vermin. I've got a wasp nest in my ceiling too. You can see the sky through there if that cardboard's not there.
started spray painting outside and doing stuff like that, but that's almost just because I only did that the other day because I did the piece out there because I knew every morning when I woke up and was having coffee, it would make me giggle. Because, see, look, if you come right here, this cracks me up. So we had a bunch of people over for cards, and I thought about doing it the night before because I'm like, you know, I don't want to be sad in the morning anymore. I need a little pick-me-up. So I knew if I just went right there and spray-painted my tag super huge, I could get my coffee in the morning and just laugh to myself. So that's about it.
I don't know. I'm just worried about you. I mean, for real.
No, I don't think you need to be.
Well, I mean, since you've moved to New Orleans, like, basically, you've gotten, like, hit by a car. You know, you got thrown in jail. You know?
I'm okay. Trust me. I am okay.
Why do you still not care?
I don't know. Let me see. I don't know. Really don't know because I don't want to come up with some like stupid, like wounded puppy. Mercy was talking about a few friends of ours whose names I will not mention about blaming certain aspects of their personalities on child and the way they were brought up. And that's possibly, I'd say that's probably it, but I don't want to bellyache about it. Because it's not like I dislike who I am. And I actually do like who I am. And, you know, it's just different ways of dealing with stuff. Gabby's called me like twice in the past couple of weeks. And she's on a whole bunch of antidepressants. So she says her sex drive is completely killed. She seems happier. She's teaching English at the university. She started drinking again, but she doesn't seem as bad as she was, which is completely incoherent. So that's good.
What about you?
What?
How have you changed?
I don't think I have.
Do you think you ever will?
No.
Can't you see I'm calling?